Oh, he's on Kobeyashi. I thought he was doing level 2 modes. Oh, this could be huge then.
I got warp 9.
Get that 9.1.
Oh! Yes!
Oh my god! This could be huge!
Let's go!
See, he's doing the strategy I was like picking on him about the whole day, the whole week. He got to warp 9.1, which doubles his score, doubles the playfield for a certain period of time.
A so his set. Look at all this. 1.8. Woo! Clip that.
That
clip
needs that. To be highlighted. Clip it. Clip it.
I passed him in one shot.
It feels like the game's a lot faster than Pinball Arcade in certain regards, and their tables are quite unique, very complex. I think it's really cool. If you guys haven't played any of the Zen Studios tables, you should probably check out some of their table packs. It's really fun stuff. Doka Dosa is playing Zen Pinball right now. You use Zen Studios, right on. Yeah, so just a heads up, people, you know, this is actually kind of in response to Ashendari99, that user's comment. Some people think that you're not supposed to touch pinball machines, like smack them or move them or anything like that. Pinball machines are meant to be pushed and nudged and shaken up, basically. That's what the tilt bob inside the machine's for. And if you don't want people kicking a machine, bolting the machine down isn't going to keep them from kicking it. It might actually make them want to kick it more. When you bolt it down, it might be harder to actually smack the machine and move it to keep your ball in play within the limits of the tilt bob, obviously. But there are some operators out there that have this misconception or this notion that pinball machines shouldn't be touched. Outside of like the flipper buttons. They shouldn't be smacked, they shouldn't be nudged at all. But that's what they're built for. They're built to be moved. It's a part of the game. I mean, even the pinball designers will tell you the exact same thing. And these are the guys making the game. So they're meant to be pushed. They always have been. And that's what the tilt mechanisms are for. If you don't want somebody moving a game, tighten the tilt. If they try moving the game, they're gonna lose their ball or lose their whole game. There's a tilt mechanism called a slam tilt where, say, if I went to Star Trek right now and I kicked it on the coin door really hard, I would probably get a slam tilt because there's another switch inside the coin door that'll activate when I do a really hard maneuver like that or a hard action against it. Hey, knocker lover. So if I say kick Star Trek, I'll lose my game completely. So it's not really ideal. Yeah, I totally understand, Braveall. And honestly, if it's your baby, you probably shouldn't have it on location. That's what home collections are for. You know, if you want a pristine game that's never going to get worn, just leave it in your house, don't power it on, and just look at it. I mean,
and leave some blankets on it.
Yeah, leave some blankets on it. I do that. I just don't want my cat scratching up my Invisiglass. Because those are expensive. And I need it for the stream. But aside from that, yeah. I mean, if you're going to operate a game, you should maybe just go buy another game and put it on location. You can buy an old game that's already beat up, you know. But I mean, eh, it is what it is. Do your best Jack Danger impersonation. I don't know how to impersonate Jack Danger. See, I can't impersonate Jack Danger without sunglasses. And I don't see any sunglasses here. I also don't have any whiskey. It probably fixed itself. You don't have to come down and relieve me, man. I already ate.
Oh, cool. Wow.
If you want to go sleep again.
Oh, that sounds really good, actually.
I don't...
All right, I'll just get another hour, maybe. You sure you're okay?
Oh, I'm totally cool. Dude, I just put a little...
Over there?
Yeah, I ate it here.
I granola, that was pretty good.
I may have... Half of my breakfast may have exited my body already.
Yeah, I
think
that's
hot.
That's
probably
true.
Yeah, man. Wow. Nice. Dage Oliva. DJ Oliva? Djoliva. Thank you for the $25 donation. We wish everybody the best of luck. I hope the stream is a big success. Thank you very much. That is awesome. Thank you very much. Hell yes.
I got the multiplier. What are the other good ones?
Which multiplier? Oh, you got Klingon three deep. Okay.
Yeah.
Save the Enterprise, because that does right ramp. Or Nero, which does left ramp, or left orbit. I think Nero's left orbit, right? Yeah, because Destroy the Drill was upper warp ramp. Which, that would have been nice on that double super jackpot.
Yeah.
That would have been an 80 million shot. Potentially 120, because technically it was a combo shot. Well, no, I probably got my math wrong. Yeah, I think if Rudy takes off his pants, we won't be able to stream for the rest of the week. So as much as you guys might enjoy that, we're going to have to pass on that, unfortunately. $0.25 a game on The Walking Dead is a pretty good price, though, honestly. See, I'd be okay with that if it was $0.25 a game. But usually a game like Walking Dead is like $1 a play, you know? So if he was like, it's $1 to play and you can't touch it, I would probably just choose to not play it. That's interesting. Oh, crap. Just bear with me here for a second. Oh, there we go. Okay. Thanks again to anybody that's stopping in from the AGDQ mainstream. Just remember that we are all subs and donations on this channel and t-shirt purchases. All the proceeds do go to prevent cancer as well. We are the side events for AGDQ. We're actually at AGDQ. You can actually sort of see the main doors behind Tim's head. That's where the mainstream's going on. And... I completely lost the chat because I hit the back button on the mouse. So I apologize for that, guys. I completely lost what all you guys said. Up until, and 1 year back from Final Code. Well, Boomerski, I mean, to be fair, the games I'm talking about are like brand new in-box games as well. I mean... So we have a Metallica, Game of Thrones, Walking Dead on location near me, and Hobbit. And they were all $1 to play a piece because they were all bought new in box. You know, we're talking $4,500 to $5,000 that the operators have to make that money back on. And they're splitting the cost 50-50 with the location. So we have like a bar that a lot of machines are at. $5,000 is a lot of money, and... You got to think these guys are in it to profit off their machines as well. It takes a long time to pay off those machines if it's not a super busy location. And in my case, in my area, it's definitely not super busy. You know, it's really, they get most of their play on league night, and that's about it. So we're really fortunate to have those machines on location, so I don't mind paying the dollar. Plus, you can get deals where it's like three for $2, and then you still get replays, you get free games. Someone like me, I can make that $2 last a really, really long time. So, you know, we just deal with it, basically. So, what's the most obscure pinball jargon I know? I don't know. I think Tim's answer would potentially be a lot more interesting. But he's having a good game, so I can't interrupt him yet. Yeah, he's at 145 million. He's channeling the inner Austin. Very nice. Very nice warp ramp. See, another beautiful drop catch. So, when the ball comes down to the flipper, and if you drop it at the right time, the flipper would absorb the ball's impact, and the ball would just kind of like stick to the flipper, basically. It's a really awesome maneuver. That's a beautiful live catch right there, where the ball comes down, and you smack it right at the right time. You stop the ball dead in its tracks. Or the ball bounces just enough to where you can at least stop it enough to where you can still capture it. Yeah, very, very smooth moves, Tonda Gosa.
That might be my first drain.
Is that his first drain? He's got the extra ball.
I think I have two. We'll see.
Oh, he's on Nero 3. Okay, I haven't even seen this. Two shots left.
Yeah, the shots are being a pain in the butt. They keep moving like when I shoot them.
They move every time you flip.
Oh, really?
Yeah, one flipper pushes it one way, the other flipper pushes it the other way.
Okay, interesting.
I remember watching Zach Sharp do this on his video. He was explaining this mode specifically. You finished it?
Yeah.
Oh, man. So he's got the left spinner at times, too, and the left ramp at times, too, permanently. That can be huge. Huge points. Are there incentives that come with shirt purchases? I don't think so. I think it's just you get the shirt, money goes to charity. Jordan Insane, I don't want to mess with Tim right now. He's having a really good game. We'll talk about it in a minute when Tim's done. I'm pretty sure you buy a shirt, you just get a shirt, and the money goes to charity. But subs to the channel do get actually the Pinball Arcade starter packs. Which comes with, I think it's Theater of Magic, Ripley's Believe It or Not, and two other tables.
Oh.
Hey, Pinball Howard, how are you doing, man? Long time no see. The history of pinball from Timballs. That was last night. Yeah, that was right as they were setting up Tron, I believe. So, the potential of this game is huge. And this is some really, really big potential. Very nice, very nice. That was a good nudge. You see how he nudged the top right slingshot into the ball? That pushed the ball up higher, so instead of rolling to the out lane, it rolled up into the targets and came back. That's what nudging's about in pinball, and it takes a long time to get used to nudging like that, or being able to pick out those scenarios on the fly, because you can see how fast the ball is moving back and forth up and down the playfield. It requires split-second timing. That's one of the most like rewarding things about pinball, though, is it's so fast that when you can get those skills down, it feels so rewarding. Yeah, draining in pinball, you is basically losing your ball. That's it. Your ball goes down the drain, down the middle. Even if it goes on the left or right out lanes, it always ends up down in the middle. Think of like a sink drain, you know?
25 million
But draining, I guess you could, yeah. You could use it as a, or say it as a verb, I suppose. And actually, people do. But you could also look at the middle as the drain. You can look at it as a noun as well. It just depends on how you use the word. Yeah, another beautiful live catch there. Tim is killing it, honestly. This is great. This is awesome to watch, actually. Because he was like, I don't know if I can get a good score. No, he's killing it. He's like... He's actually getting closer to Enterprise Amok than I did. He's on his level 2 modes. And he's done Nero to level 3 as well. He's got the potential to get farther than I did, even in terms of score, with the setup he's got going right now. And he's got an extra ball. Look at that, he just got 2 million for one shot, and then he got a gold medal. Because he has that left orbit at times 2. And he's got that left ramp at times 2. And he just got times 2 for his final shot. Which, if that final shot was on one of his other multiplied shots, that would have been like an 8 million point shot instead of a 4 million point shot. So much scoring potential here. What do you call it when you lose the ball down the sides? It's the same thing. It's a drain. Or you can call it an outlane drain because they're outlanes. And if you drain it down the center, you can call it a center drain. You got a kickback. Oh, I'm not talking smack. I'm congratulating him. I love seeing pinball played like this, man. The thing about pinball is that, like, you can get... you can have really, really bad games, many back-to-back. And what Tim's doing right here now is something you don't see all the time, and that's what's awesome about this. He just got another lock lit. That was a nice little... Obviously not a control bounce, you know? He just got kind of lucky. The ball bounced there. I think he's on Vengeance Battle right now. He's got it lit.
Kobeyashi lit.
Oh, he's on Kobeyashi. I thought he was doing level 2 modes. Oh, this could be huge then.
I get warp 9.
Get that 9.1.
Yeah.
Oh!
Yes!
Oh my god! This could be huge!
Let's go!
See, he's doing the strategy I was like picking on him about the whole day, the whole week. He got to warp 9.1, which doubles his score, doubles the playfield for a certain period of time.
A so his set. Look at all this. One. Whoa! Woo! Clip that.
That
clip
needs
that.
To be highlighted. Clip it. Clip it.
I passed him in one shot.
Look at this, man. This is like the replay of Drew and I the other day.
By the way, I'm still on ball one.
You're still on ball one. Oh, my God. That's amazing, man. Blow it up. Blow it up.
All right, let's go. Let's go. I got too excited.
Oh, Drew as in Osric. He's one of the hosts here on Pinball Done Quick this week. Wow, I can't believe you did that.
Yeah.
I mean, like, I'm still, like, shocked. We got to see that live. That was awesome.
And because I had gone through so many of them.
Yeah. the values were high.
Yeah. Wait. Oh no. We'll take a mode into it.
That was insane, yeah.
Oh yeah, Kobeyashi or Pinball multi-ball. Wow, the fun never stops.
That was yeah, totally insane. See, now he's got Save the Enterprise level 2 stacked in with his Klingon multi-ball, which is really... I actually did the exact same thing. So he can actually get a lot of points from this. He got a 1.8 million jackpot, but then he also got something else, which is probably worth like 2 to 4 million from Save the Enterprise. He's already beaten my score. He's at 500 and... He just got a 12 million super jackpot. 524! This is insane. Oh, and there's no Adderall lit either, unfortunately.
The ball's stuck, but...
Oh, you got a ball stuck.
It's going to come out in ball search.
Is it in the VUC?
Yeah. Above the VUC.
Oh, it's above the VUC. Oh, he's got a ball stuck. He has a ball stuck right here.
There it is. Got it.
Right there. There it is. That's a shame, man. But still, I mean... You still got like 40 million from that multi-ball.
Yeah.
With barely doing anything. Now he's in Vengeance Battle. Now if he can complete this, he gets awarded a certain percentage of his score. Now what's cool about this mode is...
Oh, come on.
What's really cool about this mode is that even if he drains here, when he starts his next ball, the mode is still going. Unlike the second Vengeance mode. And what he wants to do is try to combo the last shot if he can. All right, so now the drop target came back up. He needs to hit the drop target. Now hit a ramp real quick. Bam, and hit the center shot. And it looks like he didn't get it. He's got to hit the drop target again. But no pressure because he's got extra balls left over. 109 million just for one shot. He's at 659 right now. Tim is destroying it. He puts my game to shame. Well, maybe aside from the double super jackpot, but he puts my game to shame aside from that. That's, oh man. I think he's actually channeling the inner Steve Bowden or Keith Elwin. No, I'm just kidding. Steve Bowden. Bowden was doing this. I think Steve got like 800 million last year or something on one of his games. And I don't even think he made it to Enterprise Amok. It was absolutely insane. Yeah, Osric, right? Dude, Drew's in the chat. He's like, holy.
It's alright, we got ball search to do this.
Where's the ball stuck?
On the pop.
On the pop, place, yeah, that's been happening. Wow. It's so good it woke up Drew. This is absolutely crazy, man.
Oh, wow.
670, what's your bonus at? Did you get any multipliers? That's why you want to get your bonus X up in this game. It can be worth something. 45 million. He's still on ball one. Oh, man. Yeah, getting stuck on the pop is a Star Trek thing. It's very common. Yeah, so if he didn't have any extra balls, technically this would be ball three. He's played two extra balls now. Actually, technically, wait.
Why not?
What are you doing right now? Are you going back to Vengeance multi-ball? Vengeance multi-ball, yeah, that's...
It's there. Take a mode.
Technically, I guess this would be ball four. Five, six, seven,
no,
I don't even...
three.
Yeah.
The real ball three, right.
I don't think there's a hold bonus in this game, but like you do get bonus for how many missions you've gone through. So, I mean, that can act as a form of hold bonus in a way. But like bonus that you might get for like random switch hits, I don't think there's a hold bonus. If there is, I haven't seen it. Yeah, so like, when he drains his ball, you can see it'll say like 11 or 12 missions completed or... missions accessed or whatever. And so he got like 3 million just for his missions. And then multiplied times 7, for 21 million. And then there was whatever else he was getting, like switch hits and things like that. Yep, if you tilt, tilt and lose your ball, you get zero bonus. Yeah, Tim did sleep during most of yesterday, so his plan was to sort of work the overnight shift. Because we have a lot of people working the Pinball Done Quick booth this year. Last year, it was like 4 people. It was Joe, Jack Danger, myself, and Drew Osric. This year, we've got myself, Joe, Drew Osric, Rudy Soup, Tim Balls, Kevin Manny from Buffalo Pinball, Mixer Tuna from Buffalo Pinball, and we've had some random folks just coming in and helping out too. So it's been there's been a lot more people this year. Did I miss anybody? I'm gonna feel like a jackass if I did. James the mayor. Well, you guys might actually see the mayor tonight again. He's thinking about doing an overnight shift today.
I'm draining it on purpose. Just done with that.
Oh, come on, man.
I want to get my modes done.
Okay.
Enterprise is so close.
It is, actually. He is 2 modes away from Enterprise Amok. So basically, because we have so many people working the booth this year, we can spread out the shifts quite a bit. And, I was actually, when I came into this, I was expecting to have to do overnights by myself every night, like 7 or 8 hours by myself. Which is, I'm fine with, but, it's just me sitting at the game like Tim is, but just talking to you guys. We do have an iPad up to the left of Tim, so, he can see chat and everything, but, yeah, I think it's more interesting with 2 people. We can go back and forth, we can time each other, things like that. So, Tim chose to, stay up a little bit later and get used to working overnight, and so here we are. So I think he still has energy left in him. Well, clearly he does. I mean, just look at this. Yeah, when this is all said and done, this could be over a billion, and I've yet to see over a billion on Star Trek in person. I've seen it on YouTube videos, but I haven't seen it in person yet. So, absolutely a fantastic play by Tim.
How did I save that? Jesus.
Just keep focusing, man. Just keep focusing. There's no pressure. Yeah, he had 2 tilt warnings already, so there was no saving that. No bonus X. Ooh, still 4X bonus. He's almost at 800 million. They love your shirt, Tim.
Oh, thank you.
I think Steve gets in tomorrow. I think that's typically when he comes to these things, is Friday night. Yeah, exactly, FZ. Like, with 2 people streaming, one person can just focus on their game, and the other can just, provide commentary and whatnot. So it's a great dynamic. It's one thing I'd like to be able to incorporate more when I stream pinball. It's not such a big deal with video games, but, because you have a pause button typically. But with pinball, like, you don't have that luxury. The ball's always in motion. Yeah, you can stop and cradle the ball, but sometimes that also, I don't know. I mean, you have to do that, obviously, if you're streaming by yourself. But it's great just having someone else explaining rules and just talking with you guys in general. Yeah, FZ, you can try to... there's a warp ramp loop champion, basically. So you can try to get on the leaderboard for warp ramps. But also, you can get it back up to 9.1 again and get 2 times playfield once more. So, something to try to shoot for. the best merch we've picked up at AGDQ. They don't really sell merch here. I mean, they might have like a shirt or something, but I don't. Aside from that, there's not really any merch here. They don't have like a dealer's room or anything like that. So, the best merch I got, unfortunately, I left it in my car because it's actually been pretty warm out this last day or so. Is a custom hoodie. It's got my my Twitch username on it, and it says "Pinball Done Quick" on the back. And that was courtesy of Pinball Joe. He made all the hosts' hoodies, which is really cool. So as like a thank you for helping out this week. We're all putting in a lot of hours. Working 7 days straight, about 10 to 12 hours a day.
Enterprise.
Oh, man. He's still in ball, too. He's at Enterprise Amok. There it is. Okay. This could be a billion. Should have had Warp 9.1 again, though.
I wasn't close.
Yeah.
Wow, the bronzes are worth more now.
Yep. I wonder what this is gonna be. This isn't like double scoring or anything.
That's 60. That's wow. 90 already.
Wow.
Okay.
Oh my god.
I ain't never seen this mode.
That would have been almost 300 million if that was doubled. I think you're basically at a billion now. If not, it's like 950 or something really close.
Maybe this is a single ball mode. No, I got a ball saver. Who knows? Complete all shots.
Tim is the Star Trek god. That is crazy.
That doesn't do anything. Oh, there's switches too. What the heck is going on? I have no idea what's going on. Is that it? Jeez.
Is that really it?
Oh no, okay, what is this? Oh, I got a switch, so it's an attaball. Maybe?
Oh no. Yeah, it looks like one of those modes where you hit shots and it just adds a ball. Wait, unless
that... I have
that,
no idea what.
Yeah, because I see the animation on screen.
I'm in Save the Enterprise 3 now.
Oh. Oh, you must have hit a warp ramp and got like a 9.9 or something.
Okay.
For an attaball, I'm guessing. Well, it's kind of a shame we didn't really get to see what Enterprise Amok was, but that was almost 150 million for one shot.
That's
though.
That's right. I wanted to go to 5 year.
He wants to. Oh, he's trying to go the 5 year mission now.
It's just like
he goes. He can't speed run for damn. But he can put up a score. just giving Tim a hard time. Come on, guys. Be nice to Tim. This is actually... I mean, in person, this is easily the best game of Star Trek I've ever seen.
Here's the bill.
I mean, I've never seen a billion in person. I've seen 700 or 800, but Tim has just destroyed what I've personally witnessed. Absolutely amazing stuff, man. This is great. Yeah, GG 1 billion. Hello, YouTube. What is happening now, Life Force, is Tim is destroying Star Trek. I think he doubled GC, actually. See, now this is an excuse for me to never play this game again.
You want to see if there's another extra ball on this?
I would like to, actually. that's a good...
It's a good thing to go for right
yeah. now. I would go for that 9.9.
Eh.
He's going, eh. Okay, so the attaball must have come from Enterprise Amok then.
Oh wow.
Ooh.
Dang it.
Still an amazing game though, dude. That was... I have to shake your hand after that one.
No,
I've touched Tim's hand. He put up 1.2 billion on Star Trek. Or is it just like one point something? That was insane. Absolutely insane. My.
Billion.